everything that drives my values and my policies is based in justice.
Whenever Adam Coker gets a chance to talk to voters in the 13th Congressional District, he is quick to make the point that he's a lot more like those voters than most politicians.
I think that wealthy people have enough representation in Washington.
Hey, how are you?
Kathy, how are you?
Good to see you. Thank you for being here.
His opponent, Kathy Manning, emphasizes a record of being able to work with people across the spectrum to find common ground and get things done.
I've worked with people across the community to improve access to early childhood education with United Way. I work with people during the economic downturn to help people with mortgage assistance, food assistance, job retraining, and networking to find new jobs.
At a recent meeting with some teachers, Manning says a big part of strengthening the economy...
Let me ask you a slightly different question.
...is what she calls creating multiple paths to career success.
We need career and technical training, job training, and apprenticeship programs. I have talked to lots of people in the construction industry in throughout our district. They can't find plumbers, they can't find welders, they can't find electricians, they can't find skilled craftsmen. Those are really good paying jobs.
That may be an issue on which these Democrats agree with one significant Republican.
The one thing that I agree with on the president, the one thing, is a major investment in infrastructure. And we don't see how that is going to become a realistic path now that we've had these major tax cuts. We do need to look at corporate tax cuts in our country, and we also need to consider letting those who make over $250,000 or $400,000 a year paying more to invest in the success of others in this country.
But the number one issue for both of these candidates is health care, and their family lives inform that position greatly.
I have a three-year-old son. He had a $500,000 procedure to save his life and open heart surgery.
My son wants to say hello. You want to say hello, Elliot?
Hello.
I met many people who didn't have health care in that hospital, at Levine Children's Hospital in Charlotte, and I made a decision to fight for Medicare for all for the rest of my life in this country. Plenty of people want off the emotional roller coaster of the for-profit health care system. This is simply the next step. This is about an option. This is not government-mandated health care.
Kathy Manning's daughter developed a chronic illness when she was only 20, a pre-existing condition that requires medicines that cost $10,000 a month, and that taught her much the same lesson.
We have to have people in Congress who are willing to stand up to the big pharmaceutical companies, and that did not happen when the Affordable Care Act was put together. They accomplished expanding the number of people who have access to insurance, but they did not accomplish making health care more affordable. And we need to work on that.
Democrats get to make their choice between these two on Tuesday. Bob Buckley, Fox 8 News.